Hello everyone, yeah, this is Abhishek Devi. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I hope you are all studying well. Last class we completed the first chapter of your class 12, Relations and Functions, right? So in this session, I am going to start the second chapter of your class 12, that is called Inverse Trigonometric Function, simply call it as ITF. In this chapter, we are going to study domain and range. Domain and range of inverse trigonometric function. Then properties of inverse trigonometric function. Then we are going to solve some problems based on the properties of inverse trigonometric function. And in this chapter, you are going to get totally 8 marks for your annual examination. 1 question for 1 mark, 2 question for 2 mark, that is equal to 4 mark, this is equal to 1 mark, and 1 question for 3 mark, this is equal to 3. 4 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 1, 8. Totally, you are going to get 8 marks in this chapter. And remember, this chapter is not only important for these 8 marks, it is very basic need to study the upcoming chapters of your class 12. That is to study the continuity and differentiability, application of derivatives, integrals, application of integrals. For all those chapters, you should know the results of inverse trigonometric functions. Yes, in our class 11, we are already studying the trigonometric functions, right? There, we studied the values of trigonometric ratios for standard angles, signs of trigonometric functions, and functions for negative angles, some important formulas. So, these are the basic requirements to study the inverse trigonometric function. Without these basic, we are not able to understand in inverse trigonometric function. See, values of trigonometric functions for standard angles. Totally, there are 6 ratios in trigonometry, that is sine, cos, tan, reciprocal of sine, cosecant, reciprocal of cos, secant, reciprocal of tan, it is cot. Standard angles are 0 degree, 20 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. See, these are in degree. In radian, this is 0, this is pi by 6, this is pi by 4, this is pi by 3, this is pi by 8. See, what is sin 0? 0, sin 30, 1 by 2, sin 45, 1 by root 2, sin 60, root 3 by 2, sin 90, 1. For cos, in reverse of that is 1, root 3 by 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by 2, 0. Then tan, sin by cos, right? 0 by 1, 0. 1 by 2, root 3 by 2, 2 to get cancelled, that is 1 by root 3. This is 1, 2 to get cancelled, this is 3. 1 by 0 is not defined. 1 by 0 is not defined. So, here we read this sin 0. See, sin 0 is equal to 0. Sin 30 is equal to 1 by 2. Sin 45 is equal to 1 by root 2. So, in inverse trigonometry, if I consider the function y is equal to f of x, what is inverse trigonometric function? See, f inverse of y is equal to x. Similarly, sin x is equal to y. What is x? It is sin inverse of y. So, we read sin 0 is equal to 0. See, sin 0 is equal to 0. This implies 0 is equal to sin inverse 0. 0 is equal to sin inverse 0. Similarly, sin 30 degree is equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, 30 degree is equal to sin inverse of 1 by 2. So, this is how we are going to learn the inverse trigonometric functions. So, we should know the values of trigonometric ratios for standard angles. So, then I want to sines of trigonometric functions. See, I already told you there are six ratios in trigonometric function: sine, cos, tan, secant, cosecant, and cot. See, if I consider the graph, complete one rotation is equal to 360 degree. See, from this to this, this is 0 degree. This is 90 degree. From this to this, 90 degree. From this to this, 270 degree. From this to this, again 360 degree. Here we have four quadrants. This is first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. See, here we are going to use ASCC rule. I hope you all remember this. See, ASCC. All student take coffee. All student take chart. Whatever you want of your chart. See, all student take coffee. This means all. In from 0 to 90, all trigonometric ratios are positive. All there are 6 trigonometric ratios: sine, cos, tan, secant, cosecant, cot. All are positive in the first quadrant. Student refer sine and cosecant. Sine and cosecant in second quadrant, sine and cosecant are the only two ratios are positive. According then T, all student take the first one, tan and cot. In third quadrant, tan and cot are positive. Take coffee or chart. This refers cosine and secant. Cosine and secant, these two ratios are positive in fourth quadrant. So we should remember the ASTC rule. This is called ASTC rule. In first quadrant, all ratios are positive. In second quadrant, sine and cosecant are the only positive. Tan and cot are the only positive in third quadrant. And cosine and secant are the only positive in fourth quadrant. For example, if sine of pi by 2 minus theta. If the examiner has sine of pi by 2 minus theta. See, sine of 90 minus theta. Sine of 90 minus theta implies what? Sine changes to cos. Pi by 2. Pi by 2 is in first quadrant. In first quadrant, all are positive. Therefore, it is positive. It is cos theta. See, according to first rule, 90 minus theta, 90 plus theta, and 270 minus theta, 270 plus theta. In these angles, sine changes to cos, tan changes to cot, secant changes to cosecant, and conversely, cos changes to sine, cot changes to tan, cosecant changes to secant. But in 180 plus 180 minus and 360 plus 360 minus, sine remains sine only, cot tan remains tan only, secant remains secant only, and cos, cot, cosecant remains same, which you are already studying in your class 11. So, ASTC rule is a very important tool to study the trigonometry and inverse trigonometry. We are in inverse trigonometry, we should need this ASTC rule. Please remember, okay? Yes. Then I move on to the next basic tool, that is functions of negative angles. See, what is sine of minus theta? It is minus sine theta. Similarly, cosecant of minus theta, cosecant is the reciprocal of sine. Therefore, it is minus cosecant theta. Then tan of minus theta is equal to minus tan theta, and cot of minus theta is equal to minus cot theta. But if I consider cos of minus theta, this is equal to cos theta, and secant of minus theta is equal to plus secant theta. We should remember this. These properties also we already studied in your class 11, right? So this is for the functions of negative angles. Then the next important rule is important formulas which we are already studied in your class 11. See, what are the basic identities of trigonometric function? Basic identities: sine square x plus cos square x is equal to 1. 1 plus tan square x is equal to 1. So is equal to what? Secant square x. 1 plus square x is equal to cosecant square is equal to cosecant square x, then we should remember sine of a plus b, sine of a minus b, cos of a plus b, cos of a minus b. See, sine of a plus b is equal to sine a cos b plus cos a sine b. Sine of a minus b is equal to sine a cos b minus cos a sine b. Cos of a plus b is equal to cos a cos b minus sine a sine b. Cos of a minus b is equal to cos a cos b plus sine a sine b. See, we should remember this. Okay, then what about tan of a plus b and tan of a minus b? Tan of a plus b is equal to tan a plus tan b divided by 1 minus tan a into tan b. Tan of a minus b is equal to tan a minus tan b divided by 1 minus tan a into tan b. See, then we have, then we learned sin theta is the reciprocal of cosecant theta. Cosecant theta is the reciprocal of sin theta. Similarly, cos theta is the reciprocal of secant theta. Secant theta is the reciprocal of cos theta. Then tan theta is the reciprocal of cot theta. Cot theta is the reciprocal of tan theta. Then we should remember sin 2 theta, cos 2 theta, and tan 2 theta. What is sin 2 theta? 2 sin theta into cos theta. In terms of tan theta, 2 tan square theta, 2 tan square theta divided by 2 tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. What about cos theta? Cos square theta minus sin square theta. In terms of tan theta, 1 minus tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. Tan 2 theta. It is tan square, 2 tan square theta divided by 1 minus tan square theta. Similarly, we should remember sin 3 theta, cos 3 theta, and tan 3 theta. See, these are all the basic important formulas which I mentioned in my notes. Please go through it, which is available in my description part of this session. Okay, you should remember all these basic requirements. Without this, we are not able to solve, we are not able to study the inverse trigonometric function. Okay, then I move on to inverse trigonometric function. Then I move on to inverse trigonometry function. See, what is trigonometry? Trine plus gon plus metric. Trine plus gon plus metric. Trine, 3, size, Greek word, metric, measurement. Metric, measurement. It is 3 side measurement is nothing but trigonometry. Basically, all trigonometric ratios. Basically, all trigonometric ratios are many one function. Sir, what is this many one function? See, there are two types of function, one and onto, which we are all studying in our previous classes, right? One and onto, these are the types of function. If these two type hold, then it is called bijective function. Then is called bijective function. Then bijective implies what? Invertible function. Bijective implies what? Invertible function. A function is invertible if and only if it is bijective. That is, if the function is invertible, then it is bijective. That is, 1-1 and onto. If the function is satisfies both 1-1 and onto, then it is invertible. So to define an invertible function, we should define those trigonometry function should be bijective. See, I told you trigonometry ratios are many one functions. See, many one functions is the opposite definition of one one function. What is one one? If I consider the two pre-images, f of x1, consider f of x1 is equal to f of x2, plus what? x1 is equal to x2. That is, no two domain having the same image. No two domain having the same image in codomain. That is, f of x1 is equal to f of x2 plus x1 is equal to x2. What about onto? If I consider the function f from x to y, for every y belongs to y, there exists x belongs to x, such that f of x is equal to y, f of x is equal to y, then what is minimum function? See, I already told you, it is the opposition of, opposite definition for one one function. That two or more domain, two or more domain having the same image, more two domain having the same image, that is called one. Two or more domain having the same image in codomain, this is the minimal function. If minimal function holds, then it is not invertible. That is, minimal function implies not one, not one implies not bijective. So, to make these trigonometric ratios are bijective, we should restrict the domain and codomain for one and R2. See, if I consider from 0 to pi, if I consider the angles from 0 to pi, what is sin 0? Sin 0 is equal to 0. What is sin pi? Sin pi is also equal to 0. Sin pi is also equal to 0. See, two images of the domain, two domains having the same images, this implies what? Minimal function. This implies what? Not one. This implies what? Not bijective. So, first we should define, that is restrict like the domain and range for the invertible function. Then we are going to find the inverse trigonometric function. I hope you all understand why we need the domain and range. Okay? Then, the examiner like to ask the domain and range for all these inverse trigonometric functions. See, if the examiner like write the domain of sine intersects. This is for one mark. Then, what is the domain for sine intersects? It is -1 to 1. What is the range? -π/2 + π/2. I already told you. See, sin π/2 is equal to 1. sin π/2 is equal to 1. In trigonometry, π/2 is angle. This is what input. This is what domain. Then, π/2 is equal to what? sin 1. See, then this becomes input. That is domain. This becomes output. That is range. Therefore, -π/2 + π/2. It is range of inverse trigonometric function. -1 to +1, it is domain for inverse trigonometry, that is sine inverse. Okay? Then if the examiner asks, write the range for secant inverses, then you should write 0 to pi of π/2. Why except this is except π/2? Why except π/2? See, secant of π/2. This is equal to what? 1 by cos π/2. This is equal to what? 1/0. Therefore, this function is not defined at π/2. This function is not defined at π/2. Therefore, this should not belong to the range. Range is nothing but the principal value of branches. You should remember that. Range is nothing but the principal value of branches. Okay? Please note down this, the domain and range for inverse trigonometric function. So this is the first subtopic we are going to learn in inverse trigonometric function. And this is very, very important for the annual examination for 1 mark. You should remember this, domain and range. Yes, then I move on to properties of inverse trigonometric function. See, in this, first you should remember sine inverse of sin x is equal to x, but x belongs to -π/2 + π/2. I already told you, to define inverse trigonometric function, that should be both 1 and 1. If I consider 180 degree, from 0 to 180 degree, sin 0, sin 180, 0. Therefore, two different domain having the same image, that should not be equal to 1, that should not be equal to bijective, then we are not able to define inverse trigonometric function. Therefore, sin inverse of sin x, this inverse trigonometric function, this trigonometric function get cancelled only when this x belongs to -π/2 to +π/2. See, this -π/2 to +π/2 is the domain of sin x, right? See, in this function, first we are going to define sin x, right? Then similarly, cos inverse of cos x. First we define cos x. What is the domain of cos x? X belongs to 0 to pi. Therefore, similarly, tan inverse of tan x is equal to x. X belongs to domain of tan x.
cot inverse of cot x is equal to x, secant inverse of secant x is equal to x, cosecant inverse x of cosecant inverse of cosecant x is equal to x. Okay, you should remember this. We will solve the problems on this property later. Okay, first we shall study the properties of inverse trigonometric function, then move on to the problems. Okay, then the first property, those are the basic properties. Then first property is sine inverse of 1 by x is equal to cosecant inverse x. Sin inverse of 1 by x is equal to cosecant inverse x. Then cos inverse of 1 by x is equal to secant inverse x. Secant inverse x. Then tan inverse of 1 by x is equal to cot inverse x. Cot inverse x. See, what is the domain for cosecant inverse x? X belongs to set of all real numbers except minus 1 to plus 1. Then here also x belongs to set of all real numbers except minus 1 to plus 1. Cot inverse x belongs to set of all real numbers. This is the domain. Okay? Then examiner asks, prove that sin inverse of 1 by x is equal to cosecant inverse x. Any one of these for 2 marks. For 2 marks. See, to prove this, proof of A. Consider sin inverse x is equal to theta. Let us call sin inverse of 1 by x, right? Consider LHS, that is sin inverse of 1 by x is equal to theta. What is 1 by x? If we transfer this inverse function, that is LHS to RHS, inverse trigonometric function becomes trigonometric functions, right? Sin theta. Therefore, 1 by x is equal to sin theta. What is x? Reciprocal of sin theta, that is 1 by sin theta. See, what is 1 by sin theta? It is cosecant theta. That's why I told you. To study inverse trigonometric function, we should remember the formulas of trigonometric function. That is the results of trigonometric function. See, cosecant is the reciprocal of sine, or sine is the reciprocal of cosecant. Whatever we are going to prove, the properties of inverse trigonometric function, those proofs based on the trigonometric result. Okay? See, here we use the reciprocal formula. Then x is equal to 1 by sine theta. Then x is equal to 1 by sin theta is equal to what? Cosecant theta. See, what we need in RHS? Cosecant inverse. Take this LHS to RHS. RHS to LHS again. Then cosecant inverse of x is equal to what? Theta. Then call this equation 1. What is theta? Sin inverse x. Cosecant inverse of x is equal to sin inverse of 1 by x. See, sin inverse of 1 by x is equal to cosecant inverse of x. Then we get 2 1. This is based on the reciprocal formula of trigonometric function. Then similarly, cos inverse of 1 by x is equal to secant inverse of x. Let us consider proof for B. Consider cos inverse of 1 by x is equal to theta. 1 by x is equal to theta. What is 1 by x? It is cos theta. What is x? 1 by cos theta. What is x? 1 by cos theta is equal to what? Secant theta. Therefore, secant inverse x is equal to theta. Call this equation 2. From 2, theta is equal to what? Secant inverse x is equal to, what is theta? Cos inverse of 1 by x. See, cos inverse of 1 by x is equal to secant inverse of x. I leave this problem to you. Try yourself. Okay? Similarly, taking tan inverse of 1 by x is equal to theta, then what is the reciprocal of tan? Cot. Using that result, getting this. Okay? So, this is the first property. First property contains three sub properties. That is, sin inverse of 1 by x is equal to cos inverse x. Cosecant inverse x. Cos inverse of 1 by x is equal to secant inverse x. Tan inverse of 1 by x is equal to cot inverse x. Okay? Then, I want to
Then I move on to the second property of inverse trigonometric function. This second property contains six sub properties. See, 2a, 2a, 1, that is, prove that sine inverse of minus x is equal to minus sine inverse x. Similarly, cosecant inverse of minus x is equal to minus cosecant inverse x. Then tan inverse of minus x is equal to minus tan inverse x. Minus tan inverse x. But the second part said this is 1, 2, 3. Then from B it is 1 says cos inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cos inverse x. Then secant inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus secant inverse x. Similarly, cot inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cot inverse x. This is also for 2 marks in 1. Okay? How to prove this? See. Proof. For 1. Consider LHS. See, sine inverse of minus x is equal to theta for this expression. Sine inverse of minus x is equal to theta. Then, what is minus x? It is sine theta. Then, multiply negative on both sides. That is, negative to negative positive. This is equal to minus sine theta. Minus x is equal to, again, by the result. What is sine of minus theta? Sine of minus theta is equal to what? Minus sine theta. See, x is equal to sine of minus theta. X is equal to sine of minus theta. See, sine inverse of x is equal to sine of minus theta. This is equal to minus theta. See, if I multiply negative on both sides now, minus sine inverse x is equal to theta. Then minus sine inverse x is equal to, what is theta? Theta is equal to sine inverse of minus x. Therefore, sine inverse of this is equal to what? RHS. Considering LHS as theta, then getting minus sine inverse x. This is equal to sine inverse of minus x. Right? See, consider sine inverse of minus x is equal to theta. Minus x is equal to, I already told you, LHS, inverse trigonometric function, transferred to RHS, then it becomes a trigonometric function, that is sine theta. Then, negative, multiply minus on both sides, that is minus into minus plus, plus into minus, minus sine theta, using the result. Sine of minus theta is equal to what? Minus sine theta, that is minus sine theta can be written as sine of minus theta. Again, take that. That is, sine becomes sine inverse x is equal to minus theta. Then, again, multiply negative on both sides. Minus sine inverse of x is equal to theta. Minus sine inverse of x is equal to theta is equal to what? Sine inverse of minus x. Yes? Then, similarly, this one is over. I give this to as homework. Do yourself. Try to do yourself. Okay? Similar. See, what is, I already told you, cosecant of minus theta, minus cosecant theta, using the result. Tan of minus theta, right? Then, cos inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cos inverse x. How to prove this? See, consider LHS. Second one, B1, okay? Consider LHS. Cos inverse of minus x, call this as theta. Cos inverse of minus x is equal to theta. What is minus x? It is cos theta. Then again, multiply negative on both sides. It is equal to what? Minus cos theta. See, minus cos theta. Is it cos of minus theta is equal to minus cos theta? No. When the cos negative, according to ASTC rule, first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant, in first quadrant, all are positive. But in the second quadrant, sine and cosecant are the only positive. Therefore, if I consider, see, cos of 180 degree minus theta, if I write it in radian, 180 becomes
are the only positive. 180 minus 180 plus cos remains cos only. But 180 minus means in the second quadrant cos is negative. Cos of 180 minus 180 plus cos remains cos. Therefore, cos of 180 minus theta is equal to what? Minus cos theta. Therefore, see again, take back. Cos inverse x is equal to pi minus theta. Cos inverse x is equal to pi minus, what is theta? Theta is equal to cos inverse of minus x. But we need to prove what? Cos inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cos inverse x. See, take this to this and this to this. Minus becomes plus. Cos inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cos inverse x. Pi minus cos inverse x. Yes? I hope you are all getting. Okay? Similarly, this one. I leave this one to yourself. Prove yourself. Okay? I leave this to for you only. Okay? Done. Done. See, these are all very, very important. Not only for examination, these results helps you to solve the problems on continuity and differentiability, integration, application of derivatives, application of integrals. Okay? Then the next property. Next property. Prove that sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Then tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Then secant inverse x plus cosecant inverse x is equal to pi by 2. This is for 2 marks. Anyone? Here again, 1, 2, 3. The third property has 3 more sub properties. That is sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. How to prove this? See, consider LHS. Consider LHS. Cos inverse, sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Let us consider sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to theta. Or consider sin inverse x is equal to theta. Consider sin inverse x is equal to theta. Then what is x? X is equal to sin theta. X is equal to sin theta. See, I already told you. In 0 to 90, that is in first quadrant, all angles are positive. 90 plus 90 minus sin becomes cos, cos becomes sin. See, this sin theta can be written as cos of 90 minus theta. What is cos of 90 minus theta? It is sin theta. Cos changes to sin 180 degree. It is positive because 90 minus in first quadrant all are positive. Therefore, what is cos inverse x? It is equal to pi by 2 minus theta. Cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2 minus theta. Take this theta to this side. That is theta plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. RHS is what? Pi by 2. What is theta? From 1, call this equation 1. Then theta is equal to what? Sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Similarly, I leave this to you only. Okay? Try to solve this. Very easy, right? Using this property. See, similarly, if you consider tan inverse x is equal to theta, x is equal to tan theta. Tan theta can be written as cot of 90 minus theta. Then cot inverse of x is equal to pi by 2 minus theta. Theta plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Therefore, what is theta? Tan inverse. Tan inverse plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Yes? Very, very important. Okay? Then the next property, fourth one, it has two sub-properties. That is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. Tan inverse x minus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy. How to prove this? See, consider, see, proof. Proof. Consider tan inverse x is equal to theta. This implies what? This implies x is equal to tan theta. And
tan inverse y is equal to 5. This implies x is equal to tan y. X is equal to tan y. See, again, considering the result. Trigonometric result. What is tan of a plus b? Tan a plus tan b divided by 1 minus tan a into tan b. Then, instead of a and b, we have theta and y. Tan of theta plus y is equal to tan theta plus tan y divided by 1 minus tan theta into tan y. Tan y. See, this implies. See, when I take this trigonometric ratio, so LHS to LHS, trigonometric ratio becomes what? Inverse trigonometric ratio. What is theta? Theta is equal to tan inverse x. Plus, what is phi? It is tan inverse. Therefore, LHS proved tan inverse x plus tan inverse phi. Tan inverse of, what is tan theta? Tan inverse x is equal to theta. X is equal to tan theta plus y is equal to tan theta. 1 minus x is equal to 1. See, hence proved only 2 steps. We will get 1. 2 marks. This can be easy only when you are remembering the trigonometric result. Tan of a plus b. Similarly, tan of a minus b, that is theta minus y, tan theta minus tan y to 1 plus tan theta into tan y. For the same substitution, tan inverse x minus tan inverse y divided by tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus x y. Tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus x y. Very easy. Any one of these examiner will like to ask for 3 months for your annual examination. Is it clear? Yes. Then I move on to the next property. Then I move on to the next property. Fifth one. It contains 3 more sub-properties, that is sin inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square, cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square, tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. For all these, RHS is tan inverse, that is 2 tan inverse x. For all these LHS, RHS is 2 tan inverse x. How to prove this? See, consider LHS. That is sin inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. Put x is equal to tan theta. This implies what? Theta is equal to tan inverse x. Theta is equal to tan inverse x. See, sin inverse of what is 2x? That is 2 tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. I already told you. Sin 2 theta in terms of tan theta is 2. Tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. See, this is equal to what? Sin inverse of sin 2 theta. If you forgot the formula, see, you have sin inverse. To cancel this one, what you want? Sin. See, in RHS, we need to prove 2 tan inverse. So it is sin 2 theta, not 2 sin theta. If it is 2 sin theta, then we are not able to cancel this. We need what? Sin 2 theta. Then sin inverse sin get cancelled. We need what? 2 theta. This implies 2. X is equal to tan theta. Theta is equal to what? 2 tan inverse x. 2 tan inverse x. Therefore, sin LHS, considering LHS, this is equal to what? RHS is equal to. For all these, RHS is 2 tan inverse x. Similarly, if you consider for all these, you should substitute x is equal to tan theta only. Then consider the tan inverse. Tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. 2x divided by 1 minus x square. 2 tan theta divided by 1 minus tan square theta. Then this becomes what? Tan inverse of tan 2 theta is 2 tan theta divided by 1 minus tan square theta. Tan 2 theta. Get cancelled. Remaining 2 theta. What is theta? 2 tan inverse x. 2 tan inverse x. Similarly, cos inverse of 1 minus tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. 1 minus tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta is cos 2 theta. Cos inverse of cos 2 theta. Cos inverse of get cancelled. Remaining 2 theta. This is equal to what? 2 tan inverse x. This is equal to RHS. See, totally you have 5 properties. From each property, you will have 3 sub properties. You should remember in examination, examiner asks any one of these properties for 3 mark or 2 mark. 3 mark or 2 mark. Please remember this. So this completes the properties of inverse trigonometric function. In the next session, I will come with the problems, some problems based on these properties of inverse trigonometric function. Take care. Bye-bye.